In part two of our lesson on complex numbers, you will learn how to add, subtract, multiply, and divide complex numbers. In this first example, we have to add 3 plus 2i plus 1 minus 5i. All we have to do here is combine like terms. So we have a 3 plus a 1 is equal to 4. We have plus 2i and minus 5i, so that will become minus 3i. And we're already finished with this first one. Next, we have 3 plus 2i minus 1 minus 5i. So let's clear out the parentheses here. We will get 3 plus 2i, and we have to distribute this minus sign over each term, so this becomes minus 1 and plus 5i. Combining like terms, 3 and minus 1 becomes 2. We have plus 2i and plus 5i is plus 7i. In this next example, we will multiply 3 plus 2i times 1 minus 5i. And in order to accomplish this, we are going to use FOIL for multiplying binomials. This becomes first times first is 3. Outer times outer is minus 15i. Inner times inner is plus 2i. And last times last is minus 10i squared. Now we know that I squared is equal to negative 1, which means that this term here, minus 10 times I squared, is going to become plus 10. So when we combine like terms, we have 3 plus 10 is 13. This minus 15i plus 2i becomes minus 13i. In this example, we are dividing 3 plus 2i by 1 minus 5i. And remember that I is the square root of negative 1. So we have to rationalize this because we can't leave a radical in the denominator. So we will multiply by 1 in the form of the complex conjugate of the denominator over itself. So 1 plus 5i over 1 plus 5i. This becomes, in the numerator, we are going to have to FOIL 3 plus 2i times 1 plus 5i. So let's write out FOIL. First times first, we get 3. Outer times outer, plus 15i. Inner times inner, plus 2i. Last times last is plus 10i squared. In the denominator, we can also FOIL First times first is 1. Outer times outer is plus 5i. Inner times inner is minus 5i. Last times last is minus 25i squared. As we combine like terms here, you have to notice that the I squared here is going to be negative 1, so that means this plus 10i squared is really negative 10. So in the numerator, we will have 3, and this minus 10 becomes negative 7. Plus 15i and plus 2i becomes plus 17i. In the denominator, the plus 5i and minus 5i will cancel out, and we see that this minus 25i squared is going to become plus 25. So in the denominator, we have 1 plus 25, which is 26. Next up, we have 10 over I. Now, we can multiply this times 1 in the form of I over I. So now we would have 10i divided by I squared in the denominator, and of course I squared is negative 1, so that becomes a negative 1 in the denominator, and this becomes negative 10i. Here, we have to square the binomial 4 minus 7i. We know using our rule from algebra, we square the first, 16, minus, we double the product, so 2 times 4 is 8, times 7i is 56i, plus we square the second, so that would be 49i squared. We know that plus 49i squared is going to become minus 49. So this is 16 minus 49 is negative 33 minus 56i. Next up, we have complex conjugates. And complex conjugates come in the form of two binomials who differ only by the plus or minus sign. So we have a plus bi and a minus bi are complex conjugates. Now, when we multiply them, we would FOIL them out. So let's just jot that down, F-O-I-L. And when we take first times first, we would get a squared. Outer times outer, we would get minus abi. Inner times inner, we get plus abi, and last times last, we would get minus b squared I squared. Now these two will just cancel out. We have the minus abi plus abi, so those are gone. Then over here, we know that this I squared will be negative 1, so minus b squared times I squared, this term, is going to become plus b squared. So then complex conjugates, when we multiply them together, this is just going to become a squared plus b squared. And so now, rather than have to go through this full step where we FOIL it out, we can go directly to this result. So let's try that on these two problems. Pause the video, try these two, multiplying the complex conjugates, then restart the video when you're ready to check your answer. In this first one, we have 5 plus I times 5 minus I, and using the complex conjugate result, we know that's just going to be 5 squared plus the coefficient. Remember, the b is the coefficient here of the I term. Notice it's b times I and b times I over here. So the coefficient of the I is 1, and that has to be squared, so this is going to be 26. In this example, we have 2 minus 7i times 2 plus 7i, so we are multiplying the complex conjugates. Using the rule, we know we take the first term and square it, so 2 squared, and add that to the coefficient of the I term squared, so 7 squared. We have 4 plus 49 is equal to 53. Here we're going to explore powers of I. So we know that I to the 1 is just I. I squared, we know, is negative 1. I cubed, you can think of as I squared times I. We know that I squared is negative 1. So this is negative 1 times I, which is just negative I. I to the fourth is I squared times I squared, which is negative 1 times negative 1, which is equal to 1. Now that's a really powerful tool, knowing that I to the fourth can be replaced with 1. Let's take a look at what happens when we have some larger exponents of I. We can take I to the fifth and write it as I to the fourth times I. So that becomes 1 times I, which is just I. I to the sixth is I to the fourth times I squared. We know that I to the fourth is 1. We know that I squared is negative 1. So this becomes negative 1. I to the seventh is I to the fourth times I to the third. I to the fourth is 1. I to the third, we learned earlier, is negative I. 1 times negative I is negative I. I to the eighth can be written as I to the fourth times I to the fourth, which is 1 times 1, which is 1. So we can see that the pattern is just repeating. We started with I, we start with I. Then we got negative 1, we got negative 1. Next we got negative I, negative I. Then we got positive 1, positive 1. and then that whole pattern just repeats itself. Now, the reason this happens is because I to the fourth is such a powerful tool and can be replaced with 1. Now, remember, when you have a power to a power, it means you multiply the exponents. So when we have I to the 4n, that means we had I to the fourth to the n power. Now that I to the fourth can get replaced with a 1, and we know that 1 to any power is going to be 1. So we can use that now as a tool to simplify powers of I. In this example, we're going to simplify each. So we have I to the 13th here, and what you want to do is write it as the product I to the 12th times I, because 12 plus 1 gives us that 13. Now the reason I picked 12 is because it is a multiple of 4. So what you want to do when you're simplifying these powers of I is to find the largest exponent that is a multiple of 4 and then write whatever's left over in the second factor. So 13, we could get a 12 in there, which is the biggest multiple of 4, and then what would be left is a 1. So we know that I to the 12 is I to the 4 raised up to the third power, and then we still have this I. Now I to the fourth we know is 1, so this is just 1 to the third power times I, which is I. Okay, you try these next two. Simplify them as far as you can. So pause the video and restart when you're ready to check your answer. Here we have I to the 30th. So the largest multiple of 4 we could have is 28. So we would want to write I to the 28th times I squared, because 28 plus 2 gives us our 30. We know that I to the 28 is just I to the 4th raised to the 7th power. We know I squared is negative 1. I to the 4th is 1 to the 7th power, that will be multiplying times negative 1, and this becomes negative 1. Here we have I to the negative 23rd, so we can write this as I to the negative 24th times I to the positive 1, because negative 24 plus 1 would be negative 23. This becomes I to the 4th raised up to the negative 6th power times I. We know that I to the 4th is equal to 1 to the negative 6th power times I. 1 to the negative 6th is 1 times I is equal to I.